Cigar?
No, thanks.
Brandy?
Wait. Go ahead, take your photograph.
Yes, sir.
So what was the nurse's name?
Monica Stetler.
Age?
25, from Blumenstein.
Any relatives?
None.
Strangled again, doctor?
Quite definitely, with the cord of the curtain.
Just like 3 months ago.
Would you like to have the murder brought in?
Please, Fräulein.
I mean the assailant.
I don't think so.
But he?
Well, Fräulein, I'm doing my duty. Examining the corpse, taking a photograph, having police doctors at me. But I don't wish to examine the others. I leave him to you.
And the public prosecutor?
Oh, he's past being angry now.
Warning here.
I don't think so.
This third murder?
Please, Fräulein.
I mean the third accident. It's the end as far as my work at Les Cerises goes.
Oh, your reputation will be built up again, I'm sure. Look, take shot from there.
Okay, yes, sir.
Dinner was a dear big patience, fellow doctor.
Who was serious?
I reckon, sir. Who was serious? Former European heavyweight boxing champion. Now, chief male attendant at last 6 years.
And these two other bruisers?
Murillo, South American boxing champion. Also a heavyweight. And Makarov, Russian middleweight boxing champion. Murillo, the table close. Makara, it's amazing. Aurelia, the silver. Makara,
what our good patients having for dinner today?
Red a la brocha. Pardon.
Fantastic! Oh my god.
First class.
Oh man, 14th class official. Plain cooking is all we got for the dinner.
Problem done. Dinner is served.
Thank you, Sievers. You may go. The patients will help themselves.
Your inspector, last permit your activities.
It was a pleasure. Well, I'm done.
Satisfied?
Envious. If we had them with the police.
Their wages are astronomical.
Well, with all the industrial barons, such luxuries is affordable. Newton at it again.
Chrysler, as usual. Liebeschleit, the pangs of love.
Look, Blacha.
Yes, sir.
You can take away the body now.
Okay, yes, sir.
Monica!
Mervius!
Monica,
how
my
could
dear!
You do it! You killed my best nurse, my sweetest nurse!
I'm sorry, Dr. Fräulein, that wasn't me! King Solomon ordained it!
Solomon? So it was King Solomon who arranged the murder?
I was just standing right here, and he came up floating to me, and he's whispered his comments through my ears. I didn't do that.
Excuse me, Inspector, my nerves.
Well, don't apologize, sir.
A place like this wears one out.
I can well believe it.
Excuse me, Inspector. Inspector Gould express my profound regret to the public prosecutor. Kindly assure him that everything now in my hands again. Gentlemen, it was my pleasure.
Goodbye, friend doctor.
Blaha!
Yes, sir.
You can now take the body out.
Yes, sir. Come on, Jeff. We're done here.
Gently, gently.
I understand.
Novius, come sit down. Behind that tree, you'll find a bottle of brandy hidden by Sir Isaac Newton.
Of course, sir, Inspector. Another one. Inspector, I must ask you to arrest me.
What for?
But after all...
Well, you said King Solomon ordained. As long as I am unable to arrest King Solomon, you are free man.
Pour me another glass.
Oh, that's too much, man.
All the same.
There is no question of all the same. Now, hide this bottle. Your sister Bull will be angry.
Of course, Inspector.
You see? It's like this. Every year in this city and the surrounding districts, I arrest a few murderers. Not all of them, but half a dozen. Some of them really gives me pleasure to apprehend. For others, I feel sorry for. But all the same, I have to arrest them. Justice is justice. But then I met you and your two colleagues. At first, I felt angry not to be able to proceed with arrests. But now? Now I'm enjoying myself. I could shout out with joy. I have discovered three murderers with whom I can, with an easy conscience, live unmolested. And for the first time, justice is on holiday. It's a terrific feeling. Justice, my friend, is a terrible strain. It wears you out on its service, both mentally and physically. You just need a breathing space. And thanks to you, Mobius, I got it. Well, this is probably the last time we see each other.
Goodbye, Herr Inspector.
Goodbye, Marius. Give my kindest regards to Einstein and Newton.
Of course, Herr Inspector. I will.
Oh, give my kindest regards to King Solomon.
Of course, Herr Inspector, I will.
This. Oh, what's cooking?
pull out a brush, called them blue, and I think it's a liver dumpling soup. No, it's extraordinary. We usually have a light supper in the evening. And very modest one. Everything's all that new patient moved to the new building. Most appetite, Bubbles? I understand. I lost my mind too after my nurse. Marius.
Excuse me. Are I sick?
I have something to tell to you.
Well?
Don't you want to try the smoke of this soup? It's excellent.
No.
No? Marius, you know that we are not lovingly tended by our nurses. We'll be guarded by male attendants. Great hefty fellows, actually, but...
Well, that's of no consequence now.
Perhaps not for you, Mavis, but it's of consequence to me. It's obvious that you won't spend the whole your life in a madhouse. Oh, this male attendants. I expect me to act straight away.
Well, that's your affair.
Not altogether, Mavis.
A confession.
I'm not mad.
Oh, of course you're not, Sir Isaac.
I'm not Sir Isaac Newton.
I know. Albert Einstein.
Fiddlestick, not that Judge Herbert Butler that they think here. My real name, dear boy, is Kilter.
Ali Haspar Kilton?
Yes.
The author of the theory of equivalence?
The very same.
So you strangled your way into here?
By pretending to be mad.
Why? In order to spy on me?
In order to get the root of your madness.
And because poor Nurse Dorothea have stumbled upon
the truth. Yes, I know. I'm most extraordinarily sorry about that. No, orders are orders.
I understand.
And I couldn't do anything else about that.
Naturally.
My whole mission hang in the balance. Nurse Delahaye didn't consider me to be demented. Frolling Dr. Fodzant only thinks that I'm slightly touched, and to prove my total insanity, I should commit a murder.
You stand on it again?
Oh. Nasty. Thank you. What the heck? Oh, what the heck I'm doing?
And his dinner's getting cold.
Let that old idiot go on with his fiddling.
Is that a threat?
I have the most immeasurable respect to you, and it wouldn't grieve me to take a violent step on this.
So your mission is to abduct me?
If the suspicion of our intelligence service proved correct...
Now what would they be?
Our intelligence service happens to consider that you are the greatest physicist of the present time.
I'm a man whose nerves are sick, Kilton. That's all.
Our intelligence service has another consideration about this subject.
And what is your opinion?
I simply consider you to be the greatest physicist all the time, August.
How did your intelligence service get on my trail?
Through me, August. Once by chance, I read a dissertation about the foundations of the new physics. No, at first I thought it was a practical joke. But then I realized that I'm reading the work of the genius. The scales through falls through my eyes, and I tried to make inquiries about the author of that dissertation. It was the genius dissertation, but
I made no progress.
Then I informed my intelligence service. Big cuts.
You were not the only one who wrote a dissertation, Kilton. As a matter of fact, I am not mad either. Let me introduce myself. I too am a physicist, a member of Search Intelligence Service. A somewhat different one from yours, Kilton. My name is Joseph Eiler.
Eiler? The discoverer of an Eiler effect?
The very same.
Disappeared in 1950.
Of my own free will.
Eiler, excuse me. May I make a problem to you to stand with your face to the wall?
Why?
I said stand with your face
of
to the
course,
wall.
Of course. My dear Kilton, we both, I suspect, know how to deal with these things. So don't you think it would be better if we were to avoid the duel? If possible.
I agree with that.
Behind the sofa, just in case attendants will come in suddenly.
Together.
Sure. Kilton, you messed up all my plans. I thought you were really mad.
Never mind, I thought you were.
Things kept going wrong. That business with Nurse Ina, for example, this afternoon. She was getting suspicious on me, so I killed her. I'm most extraordinarily sorry about the whole thing.
Yes, yes, we know. Let's sit down.
Eiler, I assume...
No, Mebius.
You two here in order to persuade me to come to your country?
We also consider you to be the greatest physicist of all time.
Of course.
But all I'm interested now is in my dinner. It's a real gallows feast. Found your appetite, Mebius?
I suddenly have come back. Now that you two have come back to the bottom of lines, why not, I thought.
Bread, Fabius?
Yes.
Bon appetite.
Bon appetite.
Bon appetite.
Patient Butler.
Here.
Patient Ernesti.
Here.
Patient Mobius.
Here.
Head Nurse Severs, Nurse Murillia, and Nurse Makara. On the recommendation of authorities, certain security measures are to be observed. Murillia, Makara, lock up!
Have gentlemen any further requests before returning for the night? Patient Butler?
No.
Patient Ernesti?
No.
Patient Mobius?
No.
Good, gentlemen. We take our leave. Good night.
I've seen them lurking in the park last night. I saw them from a window.
It looks like a solid steel with a special lock.
They got grill up on my window. Good work, actually. And same for you, Eiler. And for Mobius. Gentlemen, we're locked up.
Like prisoners.
Unlogical. What without nurses and everything?
We'll never get out of this madhouse unless we act together.
Well, I don't wish to escape.
Mebius.
I don't see a reason for it at all. On the contrary, I'm quite satisfied with my fate.
But...
I'm not satisfied with that, Mobius. Excuse me. With all respect to your personal feelings, Mobius, you are the genius. And then a common property. And you didn't have a monopoly for that knowledge that you had. Your duty as a genius to open up your minds for us, not geniuses. Come on, Adidas. In the year, we'll give you the black tie, fly to the Stockholm, Nobel Prize.
Huh? What? Oh, your intelligence service is very altruistic, Kelvin.
Mobius, I didn't mind to tell you, but our intelligence service had the consideration that you solved the problem of gravitation.
Yes, I have.
Excuse me. You say that as if it were nothing.
How else should I say it?
Our intelligence service would believe that you would discover the unitary series of particles.
Oh, they can set their minds at rest as well. I have solved it too.
The basic formula?
The very same.
It's ridiculous. He'll have physicists working in a huge laboratories, working for years and years and years, while trying to make some progress in physics. While he'll do it quite casually in a madhouse in a desk.
Mobius, excuse me, but what about the principle of universal discovery?
Something on those lines too. I discovered out of curiosity as a supplement to my physics foundations. You see, you might ask why play the innocent, why pretend King Solomon have appeared to me. But as a physicist, I have to work out the effects of my findings, and the results were devastating. If I could only imagine that they could happen in the humankind's hands, immeasurable, powerful.
That can be scarcely avoided.
Yes, and the only question is, who's got them first?
Well, you'd like that for your intelligence service, wouldn't you, Kilburn?
Why not?
And the military machine behind it?
Mobius, it seems to me, and if that can restore the level of physics in the history of the physics, any military machine is just a sacred instrument. The only question is here, Mobius, is the question of the scientific freedom. And I could give my anything to the system if they receive me alone. You understand? Yeah, no, there's a lot of talks like now that are the moral responsibilities of physics, and we suddenly find out us confronted in between two fires, but that's nonsense. Only thing that should concern us that we have had the pioneering work to do, and whether or not these people will follow the trails of our new place.
Admittedly, we have pioneer work to do. I believe that too. But all the same, we cannot escape our responsibilities. We are providing humanity with colossal sources of power. We must become power politicians. It is we who must decide on whose favor we shall apply our knowledge. And I, for myself, decide. Whereas you, Kilton, are nothing but a moral eyestead. If you feel so strongly about the freedom of knowledge, why don't you come to our side? We also need results.
Ayla, both of our political systems now must hit the Mobius hands.
On the contrary, he must do what we tell him. We got him finally on check.
Does it look like a state limit for me, Ayla? No, we are now facing the impossible situation, like a Mexican duel. If the Mobius will decide in your favor, I will be helpless, because you will stop me. And if he will decide in my side, I would stop you and you will be helpless. So, it's not we who had the chance to resolve this problem. It is you, him, who had this choice.
Let us retrieve our guns.
If you want, let's do that.
I'm sorry this affair is moving to a bloody conclusion. But we must fight it out between us and then attendants. If need be, with Mobius himself. He will be the most important man in the world, but his manuscripts are more important still.
My manuscripts? But I've burned them.
Burned them?
What? I
burned
to,
them?
When the police was here, so as not to be found.
What? Then stand. This was 15 years of war, Mobius, and you have burned them! Burned!
Shall we go on with the dinner?
I lost my appetite! Perfect.
Here we are, three physicists, and the decision we have to make is that one that we have to make as a physicist. And we shouldn't be led by our personal feelings, but by our logical processes. As a physicist, we have to think. Why don't you understand my position here? To me, basic facts are clear, but I don't understand your position, each other's. Now, you're saying that you want to preserve the freedom of science, and it owes its freedom to no one but itself. Whereas you are your power politicians, and your power politicians and country, that's what you think. Now, I must know the clear position here if I have to make a decision.
Morbius, but you know, there's a lot of physicists. They're waiting to welcome you. And, you know, but it's a condemnation, but anything could not be better, but they're waiting for
but
you.
Are these physicists free men?
But they devote their life to solve their physical problems. They need to defend the country.
So they are not free, Eiler. Eiler, your line is power politics. But that requires power. Have you got it?
You misunderstand me, my boss. My political power, to be precise, relies in the fact.
Would you be able to persuade that party to stay here? Or is there a chance of that party persuading you?
It's ridiculous. I can only hope that they will follow my recommendations, nothing more.
Are your physicists free men?
Well, naturally, we also need them to our defense of country.
Oh, extraordinary. Each of you is trying to palm off to me a different theory, but the reality you offer is the same in both cases. A prison. Well, I prefer this madhouse instead. Here at least I can be independent from all these power politicians.
But certainly one must take certain risks.
But there are certain risks one might not take. The destruction of humanity is one. Now just imagine, you already know what a world can do with the weapons it has. Just imagine what it could do with the weapons that I have. With my findings, with my theories, because my revolutions could change the world. But I was poor and I had wife and two children. There was university tempting me with fame and industry tempting me with money. I had to choose between them, but responsibility made me choose another passion. And I chose this madhouse instead. I threw up my academic career, I abandoned my family.
No, but my best, that could not solve anything of that.
Because reason demanded taking the risk. As a physicist, we go beyond what humankind... Just imagine what humankind goes about. They don't understand our physical laws. And I knew that. But I already knew. And I had to take that knowledge back to me. And I have. That's what I'm asking you. To do the same and to stay here and... with me in this madhouse.
What? What do you mean by that?
I mean, you should stay.
You don't say that.
We?
Us? We? Ada?
Both of you.
But, Morbius, excuse me. You cannot accept us to stay here in this madhouse and...
Well, you have radio transmitters, right?
Well?
Well, you can say your intelligence service that you did make a mistake, that I was mad.
They would be stuck here forever.
And that's what I'm asking you. It's our only chance that we could think our own thoughts. That we could be free men. That we could be free.
But, damn it, Morbius, we are now mad.
But we are murderers, Kilton.
I, Morbius, I resent that. You should have said that, Morbius.
Everybody who takes life is a murderer, and each of us have taken it. Even though it wasn't for a purpose to kill a person. I did it because Monica thought I was a recognized genius. But she didn't understand that the mission, my mission, was to be unrecognized.
But, Morbius, here in this madhouse, that with this gunshot, with this doctor, and this hefty malnutrient, this... we came here like a wild beast!
And that's what we should be, wild beasts! That's what I'm asking you.
Is this... there really no other way to solve this?
None.
Johann Wilhelm Rebius, I'm a man of integrity. I'm staying.
I'm staying too. Forever.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for leaving the Earth a faint chance of survival. Let's drink to our nurses.
I drink to Dorothea Moser.
Nurse Dorothea!
Dorothea, you have to be sacrificed. And in return to your love, I gave you death. Now I want to prove myself worthy of you.
I drink to Iren Straub.
Nurse Iren!
Iren, you had to be sacrificed. And as a tribute to our love, now I'm going to behave like a rational human being.
I drink to Nurse Monica Settler.
Nurse Monica!
Monica, you had to be sacrificed. But let your death bless the friendship that we three have formed in your name.
Let us once again change to the madman. Let us once again be in the shade of Newton.
Let us once again listen to Chrysler and Beethoven.
And let us once again have King Solomon appear to us.
Let us be mad but wise.
Prisoners but free.
Physicist, but innocent.
Thank you, gentlemen. But now, let's take a look.
It's better for General than it is for Zan to be hung in here than among the wounded patients. He loves heroic deaths, and that is what there have been in this house. So, the private counselor put him in the corridor for the time being. Sievers, has my general administrator arrived with his minions?
Yes, boss. They are waiting in the green drawing room. Shall I serve champagne or savior?
That gang's here to work, not stuff its guts. Has Mobius brought in Sievers?
Yes, boss. Mobius! Out!
And his face was shining, and his arms weren't horrible anymore.
Mobius. On the orders of the public prosecutor, I may speak to you only with the presence of a male attendant.
I understand that, Dr. Frawley.
But what I have to say to you applies also to your colleagues. Severs.
Oh. Oh.
Nights of secrets, unending and sublime. And through the bars of my window, I see the glitter of Jupiter and Uranus talking me to the loss of the infinity.
Yeah, a blessed night. Questions are damned, riddles were silent.
Alec Jasper Kilton and Joseph Eisler, I have something to say to you. I had my suspicions for a very long time. Your conversation was overheard. Makarov, Murillo, bring in the secret radio transmitters.
Hands behind your heads.
That's funny.
Severs, the searchlights.
The searchlights!
The wheeler is surrounded by guards. Any attempt to escape would be useless. You three, get out. You alone show him a secret. You alone among men. Because it doesn't matter any longer whether you know or not. He has appeared before me also. Solomon, the Golden King.
Solomon?
This many a long year. The first time was in my study. One summer evening, the sun was still shining, and a woodpecker was hammering away somewhere in the park. And then suddenly, the Golden King came floating toward me like a tremendous angel.
She's got mad.
His gaze came to rest upon me. His lips parted. He began to converse with his handmaiden. He had arisen from the dead. He desired to take upon himself again that power was at once belonged to him here below. He unveiled his wisdom that Mervius might rate a nurse in his name.
She's gone mad. She should be locked in the madhouse.
But Mervius betrayed him. He would like to keep secret what could not be kept secret. For what was revealed to him was no secret, because it could be sought. Everything that could be sought is sought at some time or another, now or in the future. Mobius, he did command me to cast down you and rain in his place. And I hearkened unto his command. I was a doctor, and Mobius was my patient. I could do with him whatever I wished. Year in, year out, I forked his brain and made photocopies of the Golden King's proclamations down to the last page.
Oh, you are mad! Yeah, open up for us and for everyone!
I went cautiously about my work. At first I exploited only two or three discoveries, but then I found it enormous plans and factories, one after the other. I shall exploit to the full, gentlemen, the principle of universal discovery.
It doesn't exist, Dr. Frolin, it doesn't exist, universal principle discovery.
Liar!
I'm telling you the truth, he has never appeared before me. Don't you see, you're mad.
I am no more mad than you.
Then I'm gonna shout out to the whole world that you've been lying to my wife and to me. That you made her pay lots of sums of money. I'm stuck here.
You are powerless, Möbius. Even if your voice were to reach the outside world, nobody would believe you, because to the public at large, you are nothing but a dangerous lunatic by the murders you committed.
Monica.
I simply seized my opportunity. The wisdom of Solomon had to be safeguarded, and your treachery punished. I had to render all three of you harmless. I drove those three nurses into your arms. I could count upon your reactions. You were as predictable as automata. You murdered professionals. There is no point in attacking me, Möbius.
Möbius, there is no point. She's gone mad.
No point in burning manuscripts which I already possessed in duplicate.
You are mad. Do you hear? You are mad.
What you see around you are no longer the walls of Anasuya. This is the strong room of my trust. Those who give watch over you are not medical attendants. Sivers is the head of my works police. Now, my family, so ancient. My sanatorium is full of my own lunatic relatives. All of them loaded with jewels and medals. I am the last normal of my family. The last one. No more. I'm a baron. I can love no one. Only humanity. And so King Solomon took pity on me. He with his thousand brides chose me. Now I shall be mightier than any of my forefathers. My cartel will dictate in each country, each continent. It will ransack to the solar system and thrust out beyond the great nebula in Andromeda. It all adds up, and the answer comes out in favor not of the world, but of an old hunchback spinster. Sivers!
Yes.
I must go, Sivers. The Board of Trustees is waiting. Today we have worldwide operation. The assembly lines are rolling.
It's all over. Everything is over. The world has fallen into the hands of insane female.
I am Newton, Sir Isaac Newton, born 1st of January 1633 at Woolhouse near Grantham. I am the president of the Royal Society, but there is no need to get upon my behalf. I wrote the mathematical principle of natural philosophy. I said, hypothesis, non finger, I do not invent hypothesis. My works in the fields of optical mechanics, theoretical optics, and higher mathematics are not without importance. But I left certain problems, and they're all concerned with the gravitational forces. I also wrote the theological works and comments to the Saint Daniel and the Prophet John the Divine. I am Newton. Sir Isaac Newton. I was the president of the Royal Society.
I am Einstein, Professor Albert Einstein, born the 14th of March, 1879 at Ulm. In 1902, I started work testing inventions where I propounded my special theory of relativity. Later, I became a refugee because I am a Jew. It was I who evolved the equation E equals MC squared. I love my fellow man and I love my violin, but it was on my recommendations that they built the atomic bomb. I am Einstein, Professor Albert Einstein.
I am Solomon. I am poor King Solomon. Once I was immeasurably rich, and I had towns over which I ruled, and I was wise, a mighty trembled at my word. But my wisdom destroyed the fear of God, and when I no longer feared God, it destroyed me, and the cities over which I ruled are dead now. I am King Solomon. I am poor King Solomon.
I am Foss. Inspector Reichert Voss, born in Munich in May 14. I have been an inspector my entire life. I have arrested hundreds of innocent souls, and now I am sick of it. I don't want to be an inspector anymore. Since I'm a director, I can break the fourth wall and be whoever I want. So, fuck this lad, let's go mad and make some crazy stuff. So, wait for me, ladies.
Дорогие друзья, спасибо, что разделили с нами радость спектакля. На этом спектакль окончен, но не стоит отчаиваться. Впереди вас ждет еще много прекрасных спектаклей No Theater and Drama Club.
Спасибо.
Спасибо большое, что пришли сегодня. Мы очень благодарны, потому что ваше присутствие, ваши овации, ваша любовь — это то, ради чего мы стараемся. Спасибо большое. Вот сегодня ребята попросили не тянуть время и не называть их всех. Я все равно хочу это сделать. Ладно, поприветствуйте, пожалуйста, режиссерский состав наш. Диану Бесимбину. И Куанышу Тажену. Наши актеры. Камила Мукатаева. Медиус Димахмед Садибеков. Ньютон Ибрагим Муали. Рабалет Мухтаров. Эйнштейн. Бержан Абдухан. Адам Мальтазирова. Назарбия Мальдива. Игнят Мартаза. Ахмур Гонзабилова. Ачель Канахур. Аляна Аглаева. Исултан Тамын. Тимирлан Баридай. Адушка Зардамиев. Дмитрий Лев. Сегодня нам аккомпанировала моя сестренка Шакирова Малатаджан и Балжан Абрагимов. Если хотите обнять актеров, приходите. Заходите. Thank you.